Hi guys, I welcome you all to this lecture, Smart Kira Current Affairs Mock Test, 19th June. C.R. Vishwanathan has passed away recently. He was associated with which of the following games? Kindly give me the correct answer. The answer for this is that C.R. Vishwanathan, who has passed away recently, he was related with football. It is known as football in our country, but in the outside nations, it's known as soccer. So soccer and football is one and the same thing. He was the former All India Football Federation Vice President and a veteran administrator. C.R. Vishwanathan fired on Tuesday died after suffering a heart attack. He was 85. Who among the following has recently won the $15,000 Gelfand Challenge Chess title? So you have to answer it. $15,000 Gelfand Challenge Chess title. So this is in the low category. Chess competition. So like, let us say, like there's low category, medium category, and the highest category. Indeed, from our level, it's a very big category, but I'm talking about like the grandmaster level. So like, let us say Anand Vishwanathan or number one player, number two player, number three player, they won't participate in that. So who has won the $15,000 Gelfand Challenge Chess title? The answer for this is Gukesh D. Known as the name by Gritty Gukesh, he won this $15,000 Gelfand Challenge Chess title on Sunday. He is one of the second youngest Grandmaster, D. Gukesh, and he sensationally won this this prize money as well as the chess title. He won after he defeated R. Pragnananda. He is also one of the greatest. He is also one of the greatest Grandmasters in becoming. So like, he is also one of the youngest grandmasters right now, and in future the chess masters have predicted that they will become one of the most proficient grandmasters from India. So he defeated him. He is second ranked, and he defeated him, right? So that's the answer. Which IIT has recently hosted the conference of BRICS network universities? BRICS means Brazil, Russia, India, China, and South Africa. Actually, this initiative was started with much pomp and show, but lately India and China are the only countries that are performing like that good in the economy scale, because Russia does not have, apart from the defense sector, it does not have that economy to boost. Like, we have fourth purchasing power parity, or now we have third purchasing power parity. Brazil is struggling with most of the time corruption, vaccine related issues also it had. Then it has a lot of structural issues. But China and India are growing solely because of their demographic. Because we have so many number of people that most of the countries want to come to this BRICS. And in that, India and China. So these are the driving factors. And in that, China is always obviously in the lead, because Chinese leaders take decisions fastly. We are bungled down by our democratic process. So which IIT has recently hosted the conference of BRICS network universities? The answer is IIT Bombay. Also known as IIT Bombay. So IIT, Indian Institute of Technology Bombay, its center right now is in Powai, is hosting a 3-day virtual conference of BRICS and network universities that started yesterday, that means on June 16. The conference of the theme of electric mobility. So the theme is electric mobility is a part of the engagement that India is hosting under the education stream during its chairship of the 13th BRICS summit this year. H Energy has signed a memorandum of understanding with which company to supply regasified liquefied natural gas, RLNG, from India to Bangladesh? Kindly give the correct answer. So H Energy has signed an MOU with which company to supply regasified liquefied natural gas, RLNG, not LNG, RLNG, from India to Bangladesh. Very, very simple to remember, that is Petro Bangla, because see, you have to just remember that it's petro related to, it is extracted from petrol, and because it's given to Bangladesh, then it's Bangla, Petro Bangla. So that's how you remember it. There's nothing more apart from it, except this news that H Energy is the only company to have received the authorization from PNGRB to lay a pipeline till the border of the supply of RLNG into Bangladesh. Which company has recently announced the appointment of former Adidas India executive Manoj Juneja as vice president sales and marketing? Very important, because it's very difficult to sell products, right? Even if we have given our products for 599 rupees, it was difficult in the initial years to sell our Smart Kira products. But now, like with reputation, with the quality, with the good quality mocks, it becomes comparatively easier. So sales and marketing, Manoj Juneja now is the vice president of sales and marketing, and he's enjoying this position in Timex Group. So Timex makes great watches. Like right now, I have one if I can show you. So this is one watch. This is a smartwatch. So Timex is now even entering into the smartwatch business, but otherwise, even apart from it was in the dial watch business, right? So Juneja has spearheaded the sales and e-commerce vertical for Adidas India, and prior to that, worked with LG Electronics. So a lot of experience with his in his back. So ex-Adidas executive Manoj Juneja. Which of the following companies has recently appointed Ankit Fitkariwala? So this is basically Fitkariwala as Chief Business Officer and Product Head of the company. So who has appointed Ankit Fitkariwala? Fitkariwala. So basically, you know, Parsis used to be known by their name of the occupation that they used to profess. So now, like Nani Palkhiwala, he was one of the greatest advocates that India ever saw. India, I am saying from 1947. Bharat is. And India is the same in the constitution of India's preamble, but Bharat as such has a long and glorious history. India as a state came in 1947, so it has Nani Palkhiwala, and Palkhiwala because his grandfather and father used to make palkis, like the carriers. So they were very good in that. That's why they were known as Palkhiwalas. So Fitkariwala as the chief business officer and product head of which company? So Ankit Fitkariwala will be the chief business officer and product head of 5paisa. So 5paisa Capital has said that it is appointed Ankit Fitkariwala as the chief business officer and product head of the company. Ankit Fitkariwala joined 5paisa Capital as chief business officer and product head and would be responsible for handling product development and alternative investment products with 5paisa Capital. So product development is basically that he will try to sell his product. Also, he will try to see that where I can invest alternatively. So, like let us say that sometimes the comp in some years back before the COVID, the company saw that okay, our main business is selling cars, like the major showroom, but the second-hand car market is also very huge. So like the True Sale Value by Maruti and also Car Dekho. अपना दिस पॉलिसी बाजार फॉर पॉलिसीज देन कार बाजार अपनी कार डॉट कॉम दे ऑल्सो स्टार्टेड टू सेल सेकेंड हैंड कार बिकॉज दीज आर लाइक द सेकेंड हैंड लाइक दीज आर द ऑल्टरनेटिव इन्वेस्टमेंट्स फॉर अ कंपनी बट फॉर मारुति इट्स यू कैन जस्ट क्लियरली लाइक सी मारुति हैड इट्स ओन शोरूम इट्स यूज टू सेल कार्स बट एज एन ऑल्टरनेटिव इन्वेस्टमेंट इट स्टार्टेड सेलिंग सेकेंड हैंड कार्स अंडर इट्स नेम नोन एज ट्रू वैल्यू कार. Which company has recently appointed Ravi Kumar as its chief executive officer? The answer for the same is that Ravi Kumar is the chief executive officer of UD Chalo. Now you can remember it because Ravi is what? Ravi is sun, right? Sun. What does the sun do? Sun moves, right? Sun moves from east to west, right? This is, let us say, origin point. This is east. This is west. So sun moves. So Ravi and then UD Chalo. That means Chalo, movement. So UD Chalo is a leading consumer services company for Indian defense personnel, and it announced that Ravi Kumar has been appointed as the chief executive officer of UD Chalo, right? So that's the only thing that you have to remember. You don't have to remember his CV because that is good for his employers as well as for him. We have to just remember that UD Chalo has appointed Ravi Kumar as chief executive officer, that is CEO. Which state cabinet has passed a revised scheme for farmers that will double their benefit from rupees 5,000 to 10,000? Per acre per year. So kindly give the correct answer. Which state has done that? The answer for the same is West Bengal. So West Bengal, sorry, I forgot to click. West Bengal. So West Bengal passed a revised scheme for farmers that will double their benefit from 5,000 to 10,000 per year. This at the launch of Krishak Bandhu scheme, Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee said that the scheme was promised in Trinamool Congress manifesto and it will benefit over 60 lakh farmers across the state. So if you have 60 lakh farmers in Bengal, let us say, so then farmers have a population of, like let us say they take farmers have a population of, let us say 4. So it will benefit around 2 to 3 crore people. But straight away it will benefit 60 lakh farmers because straight away it will go into the account. Which state government has announced a one-time payment of 5,000 each to small shopkeepers, construction workers, auto rickshaw driver, and unorganized labor? Unorganized labor means the one which works in not in an organized setup. Like organized setups are banking, big industries, MNCs, government jobs. So they are organized. But unorganized labor are, let us say that you want to have a POP of your plaster of Paris, like you want to have a design, or you want a plumber, or you want a person who is a freehand agent and he can paint your bike, let us say, or he can paint your veranda. He's an unorganized labor because it's not necessary that he will get a job tomorrow. Today you might get you might give him 500, 600 rupees, but tomorrow he might not have. And these are the people who suffered the most from COVID. So, unorganized laborers who have faced financial hardships due to COVID-19 pandemic and lockdown. The answer is that this one-time payment of 5,000 rupees to each small shopkeeper, construction worker will be given by. Can you give the correct answer? The answer is Haryana. So, Haryana has announced this. Answer is none of these, but the answer is Haryana. I don't repeat these options because then it gets confused because you learn by my audio voice also. So Haryana has announced that a one-time payment of 5,000 rupees each to small shopkeepers, construction worker, auto rickshaw driver and unorganized laborers will be given. International Picnic Day was observed on which date? If you don't work very hard, then I think every day is International Picnic Day or my picnic day. But the answer for the same is that International Picnic Day was observed on June 18th. So International Picnic Day is celebrated on 18th June globally. There is nothing like a hearty meal and good company amid nature. So I am from Himachal. Most of the people like from Chandigarh or from Punjab, Shimla is a 3 to 4 hour drive, right? So they come for a small picnic. They celebrate in the lush green meadows of Himachal Pradesh. They like to trek also, or most of the time, like if you are coming with the family, you would like to have a stay over, right? So people, if you are staying in a, let's say, off-road location, then they come with big jeeps or Thar. But in the other kind of things, they come with, let us say, if you are coming in a sedan, you try to stay in a posh hotel in Shimla. So picnic is a very important, the F1 driver, he takes a pit stop. Similarly, if you're working very hard, then picnics are very important. And that's why this day is celebrated on 18th June, because internationally it's taken. ADB, that is Asian Development Bank, has recently approved what amount of loan to improve transport connectivity and road maintenance in the Chennai Kanyakumari Industrial Corridor in Tamil Nadu. The answer is USD $484 million. So ADB and Government of India signed a $484 million loan to improve transport connectivity and facilitate industrial development in Chennai Kanyakumari Industrial Corridor in the state of Tamil Nadu. Autistic Pride Day 2021 was observed on which date? That's a very important question again. Autistic Pride date. Autistic, I guess it was covered in Tare Zameen Par. So Autistic Pride date. So they take a time to understand things. Autistic Pride date. Answer is June 18th. So Autism Pride Day is celebrated on June 18th every year. It's an opportunity to raise awareness among people about autism spectrum disorder so that they do not see autistic people as disadvantaged but simply as unique individuals. People with autism are often subject to human rights violation, discrimination and stigma. Autism Pride Day and Autism Awareness Day are marked to stop such discrimination. So, like you will say that what kind of discrimination can be stopped? Now, if I compare this with another disease, and I'm taking just 30 seconds of your time. Let us say AIDS were there. Now AIDS can only be transferred by blood, and if you are kissing with an infected person and that kissing has a wound which has blood and it can get transfused with your blood, or if the third most and important reason was if you are having a sexual intercourse with the person who is AIDS infected. But people, under their ignorance, at least in India and also in outside countries, did not even use to sit with people who have AIDS, which is not the reason for it becoming an epidemic or it becoming widespread, because it's not a communicable disease, right? So that's very, very important to remember. And these kind of days should be celebrated, because let's say like 500 people see this lecture, 1000 people see this lecture, so that they know that what autism is, rather than making fun of it. Which of the following date is observed as Sustainable Gastronomy Day? The answer for the same is again June 18th. So picnic day, gastronomy day, and World Autism Awareness Day, Pride Day, whatever you can call it. It is observed on June 18th across the globe. It is towards world's attention towards the role that sustainable gastronomy can play in terms of sustainable development. Gastronomy is a study of food and culture. It includes nutritional facts, food science, and cooking techniques, among other things. Which of the following state has recently launched e-Pathshala and e-Mulyankan facilities? Keeping in mind disruption of classes during the ongoing pandemic, the answer is that this e-Pathshala and e-Mulyankan. Mulyankan means what the grading teacher does, grading. So Mulyankan in English means grading. So grading is launched by Odisha. So Odisha has launched YouTube classes for students of class 9th and 10th, and the state government has again taken an initiative, which is a very good initiative of launching e-Pathshala and e-Mulyankan facilities, because classes have suffered due to the ongoing pandemic. World Crocodile Day 2021 was observed on which day? That is World Crocodile Day. I think everybody knows, everybody has seen National Geographic or Discovery, and if you are luckier enough, you have seen a crocodile in a zoo, or maybe if you live in a coastal area, you have seen it face to face. So the World Crocodile Day. We even have an idiom in English that is crocodile tears. That means not true. So I guess you have encountered one or two friends like that who profess to be your friends but who are not. So World Crocodile Day 2021 was observed on June 17th. So World Crocodile Day celebrated on June 17th to raise awareness about the need to save this endangered species from extinction. Land encroachment, dredging, pollution, culling, and invasion of other aggressive species can lead to mass-scale extinction of these reptiles. These reptiles are almost either before or almost equal with the time of dinosaurs. So they are very, very ancient animals, right? And they maintain the ecosystem in the river, because let us say that there are dead fish or there are dead bodies of animals. So they eat all of them and the river remains clean. Kenneth Konda passed away recently. He was the former president of which country? The answer is Kenneth Konda was the president, was the former president of Zambia. So Zambia's founding president, who led to his country for 27 years and championed Africa's struggles against apartheid. Apartheid is color-based discrimination, and HIV/AIDS has died at the age of 97. Right. He was also known as Kenneth Konda was known as KK. Who among the following has won the javelin gold medal in the meeting Cidade de Lisboa in Lisbon? So the javelin gold medal is won by Neeraj Chopra. So India's Neeraj Chopra won the javelin gold medal. It's like a speared thing and you throw it. So that's why I've given this image. He sent the throw with 83.18 meters and he set this javelin and he won this prize with his sixth and the last attempt. Who among the following has won the US Women's Open, beating Nasa Hathakua in the three-hole playoff after the pair finished the final round tied for a lead at 4-under? The answer is Yuka Saso. So Filipino-Japanese teenager and Japan LPGA Tour player Yuka Saso won the US Women's Open on Sunday, right? She is a dual citizen with a Filipino mother and Japanese father. Saso tied with Park Inbi as the youngest champion at the tournament, winning at the same age, 19 years, 11 months, 17 days, as the South Korean was when she was in 2008. Acme Solar Holdings Limited signed a shareholder agreement with UN Office for Project Services, Sustainable Investments in Infrastructure and Innovation. So basically, I will first explain the question. UN Office for Project Services, Sustainable Investments in Infrastructure and Innovation. Now let us say that the country has brought cars with BS6 engine, right? BS6 engine has increased the cost of the new cars by at least 1 lakhs in the lower end range, like let us say Tiago's, Centro. And for BS6 range cars above 10 lakhs, it has increased the range by 1.5 lakhs, 2 lakhs, as soon as you go. So what are these BS6 engines? BS6 are basically environment compliant. They emit less carbon dioxide, 30% less carbon dioxide. So for development of these engines, what was required was funding. Who will fund that? So UN basically funds many kind of projects like that, in terms of like hydroelectricity, in terms of let us say research and innovation, so that new and new ways can be found that can help in reducing the carbon footprint of humans on Earth. Right, so Denmark's investment fund and developing countries for developing a 250 megawatt solar power plant project in which state? So ACME Solar Holding, UN office, this UN office, and Denmark's investment fund for developing countries have developed a 250 megawatt solar power plant in which state? The answer is, if you have to remember it easily, then 250 megawatt solar plant is in Rajasthan. Rajasthan has the highest sunlight and they are going to have it here. Danishmend IFU and UNOPS and SCI. The company spokesperson said that the ACME will have an equity stake of 51% in the project, while IFU and UNOPS and IFU will hold 39% and 10% stake respectively in the project. So you can see it. If you want more to read, you can see it. Very easy. राजस्थान के अंदर प्रोजेक्ट लगा है 250 मेगावाट का. डैनिश फंड है IFU, UNOPS, S3I और एक्मे. एक्मे के सोलर प्रोजेक्ट के अंदर इन्होंने लिए हैं. अहेड ऑफ WTO's मिनिस्ट्रियल कॉन्फ्रेंस लेटर दिस ईयर, गवर्नमेंट हैज अपॉइंटेड अ प्राइवेट पर्सन एज काउंसलर इन इंडियाज परमानेंट मिशन टू वर्ल्ड ट्रेड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन फॉर 3 ईयर्स. नेम दिस पर्सन. द आंसर इज, I'll tell you the answer. It's very rare for a government to hire a person and then to name him in a sensitive diplomatic position. So it's he's representing India. He's representing in India and also he's the counselor in India's permanent mission to WTO. WTO deals with everything related to trade. So very important position and very important step by the government to engage a professional person. So who is this professional person? The answer is Ashish Chandorkar. So Ashish Chandorkar, the government has appointed this private person, Ashish Chandorkar, as counselor in India's permanent mission in the World Trade Organization for 3 years. Thank you for watching, dear guys. I hope you liked it. I have changed this version from like just merely reading and doing fastly to explaining things according to my understanding. If you like it, you can just comment. I can continue with this style very easily. Thank you very much. This is Rohit Sharma wishing you a very, very good day. Thank you.